Tip number one, oil for your car. Guys, forget about manual or regular oil. You're not gonna save anything. This oil only in case if you're gonna sell your car tomorrow. It's not worth economically to use regular oil. Just check how much money you spend on synthetic oil or regular oil, and then divide this on how many miles you can put on this oil. Usually regular oil you can use for 3,000 or 5,000 miles. Synthetic oil easy 5,000, 7,000, even 8,000 miles. 10,000 miles I would not recommend it. It's only German car things that they can do this, but don't believe them. And then you find out that synthetic oil, each mile per, I would say per gallon, which you can use for this engine, it's even cheaper on synthetic oil. And again, you protect much more your car because synthetic oil works for much longer period. They have much more advanced formula and you save your car for less amount of money. Tip number two, a lot of us ever feel that they have pee smell from your AC conditioner. How does this happen? This smell mold. And reason how you get this mold is because you use a lot of time your AC during in manual settings. If you wanna save your AC as much as possible, I would recommend to use automatic settings. In this case, computer will understand when to open air from outside of the car, when to close it. Because most of the time, if you use your manual, you press this button, which is increase speed to cool down your interior, but it's accumulate mold inside of your AC because all the time you spin your dirty air inside the interior and you never dry your AC as much as supposed to be from outside air. Tip number three, spark plugs. Guys, spark plugs is all in depends for how long you're gonna use them. If you wanna sell your car tomorrow, you can buy the cheapest one. If you wanna keep it for 50,000 miles, you can buy double platinum. But if you wanna keep your car forever, or you wanna be, I don't know, like make sure that car will run very, very nice, use iridium and not any other. Why? Because iridium is like one of the hardest melt metal in the world. And nothing can kill this spark plugs. Just use iridium. It's not gonna worth much more than, for example, compared to regular one. Maybe, yes, $10 per spark plugs compared to regular one, which is $4 per spark plugs, but how many times you replace them? If you wanna make sure that your car will run smooth, and if you don't wanna care about maintenance, just use iridium spark plugs. I think you can afford it $60 for 6-cylinder engine once per 100,000 miles. Tip number four, tires. Guys, I would say it's mostly for American people tips, because in Europe, in mostly car manual, they put a couple sizes of the tire. Some of them it's winter tires, some of them summer tires. But for example, if you are a gas saver, for example, you're Uber driver, the best tires which you can get is thinner tires. If you are some racer, it's the best tire which you can get is wider tires for better traction. And just double check, for example, sometimes some cars allow you to put even smaller rims, and for example, as on my Dodge Durango, the standard rims is 20-inch rims, but price for 20-inch tires, winter tires for this car, is the same as I put on this car, 17-inch rims together with 17-inch winter tires, which is, again, like, you don't spend money anymore on tire balance for installation for mechanic. It saves you at least like $100 each season, and it's much convenient and better traction through the winter. Number five, tire pressure. Don't forget to check tire pressure, not in your regular tires, which you use to drive your car. Also, don't forget to check tire pressure in your spare tire. And for example, most of the car right now, they put the spare tire under the knees of the car, and most of the time it's upside down. But on this car, for example, they put the spare tire facing on the bottom. And in this case, you can always check your tire pressure inside the spare tire. And again, believe me, it's not gonna be like good if you're gonna stop on highway, if you have like empty tire and you need to replace it and your spare tire is empty. I would recommend to check tire pressure inside spare tire at least once per half a year. And again, if you're gonna flip it upside down, you can do this anytime during your regular tire checking.